Hi everyone, welcome back to Earthwise Facts. Today we're diving into a fascinating story about a recent space mission that grabbed headlines worldwide. The story centers around astronauts Sunita Williams and Barry Wilmore, who were involved in the unique situation when reaching the International Space Station. You may have seen phrases like astronauts stuck in space or stranded on the ISS in the past few months, but what's the real story behind? In this video, we'll break down the mission, what went wrong, and separate fact from fiction. Stay tuned and let's get started. Let's rewind and start from the beginning. On June 5th, 2024, NASA launched the first crewed mission of the Boeing Starliner. It was a test flight with astronauts Barry Wilmore and Sunita Williams aboard.
3, 2, 1.
The mission was initially meant to last just 8 days, flying from Cape Canaveral, Florida to the ISS. However, things took a turn when, as they approached the ISS, the capsule's thrusters malfunctioned. While this was a serious issue, the crew successfully reached the ISS, where investigations began. After the analysis, it was discovered that a helium leak in the propulsion system had caused the malfunction. With the Starliner unable to safely return the crew, a decision was made to send it back uncrewed after about 2 months, on September 6, 2024. As for Sunita and Barry, they remained on the ISS, continuing developing their work. As mentioned, some headlines made the situation sound more dramatic, calling the astronauts stuck or stranded. However, NASA explained that the crew quickly integrated with the ISS team and began working as soon as they arrived.
They became seamlessly part of the International Space Station, and they did that because they're experienced astronauts and we had prepared, right?
So, were they really stranded? Not exactly. It was more like a missed flight due to the technical issues. The astronauts made it safely to the ISS and even followed their planned sleep schedule on their way there. It's how astronauts are trained, and considering this was a test mission, developments were expected.
Butch and Sunny, they enjoyed their time on station. They got to do spacewalks and they got to do lots of cool science and things like that.
And this is what the crew sustained too.
Starliner came right down in automatic mode at this point and right down the middle, even with the degraded thrusters, which was truly impressive.
We still had a lot of checks for Starliner, and those all went really well.
In a press conference from the ISS in September 2024, Williams and Wilmore conveyed their appreciation for the additional time in space. They mentioned being happy about the opportunity to continue their research and work despite missing home. Williams noted that they were aboard the ISS working with friends and looked forward to the upcoming months with excitement. Addressing concerns about their prolonged stay, Williams emphasized that they did not feel abandoned or stuck. As Sunita Williams put it, "We don't feel abandoned, we don't feel stuck, we don't feel stranded." Wilmore added that they preferred to describe their situation as prepared and committed, reflecting to their readiness and dedication to the mission.
"We've been thoroughly busy up here, integrated right into the crew."
While their mission was planned for only 8 days, Sunita Williams and Barry Wilmore ultimately returned safely along with astronaut Nick Hegg and cosmonaut Alexander Gorbunov on March 19, 2025, aboard the SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft. It was a significant time spent in space for Sunita and Barry, having the mission extend from the initial 8 days to a 9-month mission.
And splashdown, Crew 9 back on Earth.
You might be wondering, why did they stay up there for so long? If they weren't actually stranded, why did they remain in space for months beyond their original mission? While they weren't in immediate danger, NASA decided to send the capsule back uncrewed to ensure a safe return. What's worth noting is that during their time aboard the ISS, other crewed missions arrived and departed. which suggests that the situation wasn't as dramatic as being stuck in space. For instance, the capsule Soyuz MS-25 returned on the September 23rd and SpaceX Crew 8 came back in October. So concluding, the delay in the return was less about urgency and more about making sure everything was done safely. Wilmore said, "We would never expect to come back just special for us, or anyone, unless it was a medical issue or something really out of the circumstances along those lines." And while some media made this out to be something extraordinary, extended space stays aren't unusual. Take Expedition 4647 in 2015-2016. For instance, astronauts Scott Kelly and cosmonaut Mikhail Kornienko stayed aboard the ISS for a full year, double the usual 6 months. And there were no issues related to any malfunction. Their mission was to extend their research. So, if they weren't in any close danger and could have returned sooner, why did NASA extend their stay? Believe it or not, it turned out to be beneficial for both the astronauts and the mission.
If I think forward to exploration and maybe some harsh missions to the Martian surface someday, or back to the moon, you know, the adaptability of crew members, changing the timeline for their return.
Every extra day aboard the ISS allowed Sunita and Barry to contribute more to the ongoing research and maintenance. Sunita herself made history during her extended stay, setting the record for the most spacewalk time by a woman and the fourth most overall. Extended missions like this are crucial for gathering data that can benefit life on Earth and help prepare for future missions, such as those to the Moon or Mars. Their time wasn't just extra, it was time well spent, and what they learned up there will benefit space exploration for years to come. So, what's the real takeaway from all of this? Sunita Williams and Barry Wilmore were not stranded in the traditional sense. Their mission was extended for technical reasons, but they were always safe, always in control, and always contributing to important space research. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, subscribe, and share it with others. Your support helps the channel grow and allows creating more fact-based content. Before you go, check out my other video on the longest times humans have spent in space, and learn even more about life in space aboard the ISS. And if you enjoy the content, maybe also check the trivia videos. I'm hoping it is something interesting for everyone. Thanks for watching, until next time!